Now I will just use another switch formula to return the measure that I want. Again, create another measure, selected value. So the selected value is switch. And now I will evaluate my selected KPI. So depending on the selection of the KPI, I will now return. Now I have three options. First option is, option number one is returns the revenue. So the selected value, and all right, so this will now calculate, so sales revenue, that's it. So that's the first option. The second option is return not the sales revenue, but the second one is cost. So just return, you know, the column that I want. Enter, but shift enter, and number three is the last one, which is gross profit. So switch simply returns, you know, a different column based on my selection in my slicer. Where's the that's it. All right, so this is now my selected value. Here, instead of returning actual for the revenue, I will return the actual for my new measure, selected value. All right, and that's it. And this is now not revenue anymore. It's actual data filtered, and it uses, you know, the selected column. So this is AC filtered. And now I go to my revenue AC, and this is already, everything is already working. I will just rename it. This is now my generic actual measure that takes into account the year to date here, and in my previous switch statement also the selection of the KPI, the selection of the column. Enter, gross profit, revenue. Wow, so this is now revenue, and now this is a completely generic, you see, it works for everything, and you can simply use one visual and everything will work. If you want to save your real estate, quite important, then you can remove some of the headers, like for month, year, and so on. I think it's like self-evident. It's quite obvious, so you can simply put the slicer header off, and I'll just do this. For all my basic slicers here, just to, you know, keep it completely minimal and use the space for something better, which is the visualization tables and everything else. So that's it. You've got your page, and now you can simply, you know, just copy the page and use the same thing for something, you know, for different type of things. For example, let's make this a big one. We should actually rename the plan as well, but we need to just fix it the same way we did the actual. And now you can just build, you know, the tables like this, previous year, actual, plan, with all the variances that you can just reshuffle around, and you have this nice little page done with only one visual. Only one visual. Like this, and you can just add details, just add more levels. Let's create a hierarchy, like multi-dimensional, you know, multi-level hierarchy. And this is now month, this is year to date, this is, you know, revenue or gross profit. Everything is working. You can even do crazy things like, what happens if I remove the slicer? Everything still works. That's the magic of the min function, because even if slicer is not there, the minimum is still evaluated. It will return the option under one, right? One is minimum. So this works. So I always get the revenue, and my default would be monthly, right? And now, instead of using the business, showing the business units here, I will use my KPIs. Look at that. I'll put my KPIs into group, and now I've got the small multiples of the measures to understand what is the relation of gross profit to revenue, which is fantastic. Then you can do two-dimensional multiples, multi-dimensional multiples, like we had the group, and I'll just group by another field here, which creates the small multiples, two-dimensional small multiples. So I've got revenue and gross profit for all my business units or divisions and so on, like this, which is kind of crazy. And you can switch from monthly to year to date. You can compare the revenue and gross profit and everything else. And so all the ideas that you can get, just you see, it's very easy to build dashboard pages. You can just create 10 dashboard pages in like an hour or something, and yeah, you're done, you share, and that's it.